Yeah, good morning everyone. My name is Deepak Gangwar, assistant professor in Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. And today we will teach you security market. Okay, so welcome in my online class. This is my first online class which I'm giving you. Okay, so first of all, what is security market? So our subject name is itself security markets. So first comes in mind, what is security market? So security market is a component of wider financial market where securities can be bought and sold between subjects of the economy. It means where we can sell and buy securities. And which kind of securities that can be? It can be shares, it can be debentures, it can be bonds, it can be mutual funds. So all these types comes, derivatives, so all these things comes in a security market. Okay, so there are two type of markets. First is primary market and second is secondary market. So primary market, what is primary market? Where are the new securities are issued and buy or sell, where we buy new security, buy or sell new security, that calls primary market. And secondary market, where we are buying and selling already existing securities, right? So what are the functions of it? So securities market, security market for main function is what? Raise the funds. Security market are financial state instruments issued to raise funds. The primary function of the security markets is to enable flow of the capital from those that have it, those need it. Security market help in transfer resources from those which with idle source to others who have a productive need of them. Okay, so what are the types? These can be of two types. First is primary market and secondary is, and second is secondary market. Primary market, so we will discuss all these things in detail. So what are the primary markets in capital? What are primary markets in capital market? Where securities and already we are selling and buying already existing securities. Okay, so what are the type of securities? Equity securities, it can be equity shares, it can be debt securities, it can be derivatives, so and it can be mutual funds. So we will discuss one by one. Okay, so equity securities, if we are talking about equity securities, then equity almost always refers to stocks and a share of ownership in a company which by the shareholders. Equity security usually generate regular earnings for shareholders in the form of dividends, as an equity share does. However, rise and fall in value in accord with the financial markets and the company's fortune. Second comes is debt securities. Second comes in debt securities. Debt security differs from equity securities in an important way. They involve a borrowed money and selling of securities. They are issued by an individual company or government and sold to another party of a certain amount with a promise of repayment plus interest and a principal. They include a fixed amount, a specific rate of interest and a maturity date. And the amount of the security must be paid by the person who have bought this security. So means what? if you are investing your money in debt, then you have guarantee you will not be in loss. Means you will get your interest on debt securities. That is sure. Okay, so you will not lose your money. Okay, and third one is what? Third one is derivatives. So what is derivative? Derivative are slightly different type of security, which is not security market, which is not shares, and which is not debentures. It is a different type of security because their value is based on underlying asset. That is then purchase and liquidate with the price, interest, and the maturity. Data is present at the time of the initial transaction. Individual selling the derivative does not need to own the underlying asset outright. The seller can simply pay the buyer back with enough cash to purchase the underlying asset, or by offering another derivative that satisfies the debt on the first. A derivative often derives its value from commodities such as gas or precious matter such as gold and silver. Currencies are another underlying asset. A derivative can be structured on as well as interest rate, treasury notes, bonds, and stocks. Okay, so derivatives are most often traded by investments. I mentioned they don't require the seller to own the underlying asset and may only payment, which makes them favorable because they are easier to trade. Okay, so that's it for the today. Thank you very much for the class.